Howie Robbins and his team can. They call themselves the Artificial Reef Society, and they've sunk more junk than just about anyone on the planet. In all, they've sent 6 wrecks to the bottom. This time, though, they're taking on a plane.
As the divers come in from the various forward and aft doorways, they'll be able to swim cleanly through here. We've decided to leave these overhead bins on board because they don't really provide any obstruction, and we think that eventually we could be creating sort of a lingcod condominium or a rockfish condominium.
But turning this into a dive site won't be easy.
Well, the first thing we have to do is we've got to strip out all the insulation, remove all the wiring as much as we can, take out all the overhead hang-ups that a diver might find themselves entrapped with.
The team is quickly learning that airplanes are complicated machines. Miles of wire, hundreds of hydraulic lines. It all has to go.
This is just some more debris we don't need on the board. Probably come loose eventually anyway if we didn't take it off now. But there's a lot more of this still to come out in the lower part of the airplane.
Anything that might snag a diver needs to be ground down or taken out completely.
And I guess if you add up the amount of cabling that's here, there's probably several kilometers of it. So we're cutting the areas just inside where the pulleys line up, and then running the lines right through the airframe to remove all this and collecting it all up. One of the things we want to avoid is hazardous traps like this. We want a very clean and bare environment. Some areas will be too small for divers to get inside, so we're not really too concerned about that. It's really the overall access points and where it's obvious a diver will explore.
It takes months to get the airplane ready, but getting clearance for departure is another story. The airplane sits grounded for nearly 2 years before a suitable site can be found. Now, the 32-year-old Boeing 737 is about to make its last journey to the seafloor just off Vancouver Island. In just 3 hours, the aircraft will be sunk, and the pressure is on. Howie's been here before, sinking ships, but this is the first time anyone has ever sunk an airplane.
A ship is more complicated. A ship is more complicated just because it is a ship. You're dealing with decks, you're dealing with rooms, compartments. There's a flooding process, there's a venting process. A lot of factors come into play here. And once you detonate a ship, that's it. Mother Nature takes over.
Now, Howard may think sinking an airplane is easier than sinking a ship, but it is certainly difficult. So one of the problems here is that an airplane flies and water is dense. So if they were just to drop this thing, the wings would actually create lift, and the airplane would sort of fly through the water, and chances of it landing on its legs, pretty low.
If you just drop this airplane, it'll go down to the ocean floor like a leaf and probably just fall apart on impact.
The plane will be lowered into the water from a crane very, very slowly.
I mean, I can let it down as slow as possible, but controlling it when it's underwater isn't the same as controlling it when it's in the air.
At high noon, right on schedule, the plane is hoisted into the air. The team has carefully selected the time because of low tide. There won't be any current, and so far, there isn't any wind.
So the plane will nestle.
On board the barge, the systems are checked one last time. An ROV camera will monitor the progress.
The best of it all. I wouldn't even say that's 30 feet.
The bottom looks ready. It's now time to sink the plane. It will take nearly half an hour for the tail to completely disappear. From here on in, they will have to depend on the ROV. When they do touch bottom, there's a sense of relief.
There it is, oh, beautiful. Touchdown. Stay with it, stay with it.
But is it sitting in the right position? To be certain, they'll have to dive on the plane. Underwater, the visibility isn't great, but within a few minutes of starting the dive, they spot the plane looming in the depths. It's not perfectly level, but not bad for flying virtually blind. The plane is intact and upright. The flight is a success.
That was a little tense at the end, simply because we were fearful that it might not have been in the right position, and that changes a lot. It's really important that we get it exactly where we want it to be, because so much measurement was made to ensure that the cradle was built, designed, and contoured to that area. By all accounts, that's exactly what we've got.
The 737, once known as Papa Whiskey, is ready for boarding once again.
Close.